So good morning, my dear students. How are you all? Hope you all are fine. So let's start our next video. Okay, so we are repeating chapter 1. So we are doing the new topic. So our today's topic, we are going to study about sources of history. Okay, now today we are going to study about sources of history. From where do the from which source we get the information about our history? Okay, so we get the information about our history in two types. The first is archaeological source and second one is literary source. Okay, archaeological source are those sources from which, from the remains and the other materials which are left over by our early man, the information which we get from that, they are called archaeological sources. Okay, now and literary sources are those sources from which are in the written form. The sources which are in the written form, they are called literary sources. Okay, so now archaeological sources are divided into different types. First is, we can get information from artifacts. Artifacts means with the different types of arts, paintings, and paintings can be in the mural like large paintings, and the miniatures like small paintings. So we can know about the stories at that time. They used to draw the paintings and they used to tell us about the stories of that time. So we can get much information from this paintings and artifacts. Okay, now monuments and buildings. So from various gardens, palaces, forts, mosques, temples, various palaces, various towers, various clocks, great clocks and all, they all gives us information about who built it, why did he build it, in whose memory it was built, how it was built, when it was built. Okay, so from these monuments and buildings also we get very much information about our history. Then comes coins. Now coins at that time were made of silver, gold, alloys, and they were inscribed. There were inscribed many informations on that coins. The kings used to inscribe many informations. They used to put their pictures on it. They used to put their capabilities or their skills on it. Okay, so we get different types of information from the coins also. Then comes the inscriptions. Now what are inscriptions? Inscriptions are various facts which we get from that time, which are inscribed on the pillars and various other on the pillars, walls, and various other places. Okay, inscription means they were inscribed there, like they paintings were made, like different sculptures were made. From this, we can know about the story of that time. Okay, now next comes to literary source. Now literary source, I have already told you, the source which were in written form, they were called literary source. So first of all, literary source is religious literature like Ramayana, Mahabharata, and sayings of different saints and dohas, etc. gives us very much information, many informations about our history. Then secular literature, various religious chiefs, various religious communists wrote the information about their religions, okay. So we come to know about the different religions from the secular literatures. Okay, now from biographies and autobiographies also we get many informations. Now biographies are those which when one person write about the another person is called biography. So he is writing about the whole journey of that person. So from biography also we get many informations. Then autobiography, the person himself write about himself. Okay, the person write about himself only in that book, and he is giving every information about him or her in the book, that is called autobiography. So this also helps us in getting various information. Then travelers account, many travelers came to India and they find out many things. Many foreign travelers came, many other travelers came, and they found out many things. They invent something, they discovered something, and they came to know about something. All these were kept in a written records. They wrote everything. Okay, they traveled here, and then when they went out or when they were traveling, they wrote every each and every fact
facts in a book. So that we're called traveler's account. So from there also we can get different types of informations. Now chronicles means orders of events. So in the court of king there were many scholars, poets and other noble persons who used to fact out the datas. They used to write the datas on which date which event took place. Okay, so that record of events is called chronicles. So from chronicles also we get to know about different events and different things which help us to know about our history. So I'm repeating myself, sources of history, we get sources means hum kahan se hame ye cheeze milti hai, source from where. Okay, so sources of history is divided into two types. We can get the information of our history in two types. First is archaeological source and second is literary source. So in archaeological source there comes artifacts like paintings and all, then monuments and buildings, then coins which were inscribed by the kings, and then the inscriptions which were written or made. Okay, then in literary source, religious and religious literatures like Ramayana and Mahabharata, secular literature which were written by different religious chiefs, then biographies and autobiographies, then travelers' account, and then chronicles. So all these all gives us various types of information about our history and help us to know about our past. Okay, thank you.